A common-sized balance sheet expresses each line item on the balance sheet as a percentage of total assets. Thus, to create a common-sized balance sheet, you go line by line through the balance sheet, dividing each line item by total assets. These percentages form the common-sized balance sheet, which is really helpful because it allows us to compare balance sheets across companies. We can compare the balance sheets of companies that report their financials using different currencies, or we can compare the balance sheets of companies that are very different sizes. For example, Amazon had $48 billion of debt at the end of 2021, whereas Netflix had just $14 billion. Thus, Amazon appears to be a lot more highly leveraged than Netflix. However, Amazon had $420 billion in assets, whereas Netflix had just $44 billion. Thus, Amazon had 9.5 times as many assets as Netflix. This makes it difficult to compare the balance sheets of these two companies because Amazon is so much larger. A common-sized balance sheet solves this problem. After dividing long-term debt by total assets, we see that 1/3 of Netflix's assets were funded by long-term debt, compared to just 11% for Amazon. Thus, Netflix is a lot more reliant on long-term debt than Amazon, even though Netflix has less long-term debt. But a common-sized balance sheet isn't just helpful for comparing companies. You can also use it to learn about a company's capital structure and its mix of assets. For example, we can see that 2/3 of Amazon's assets are funded by liabilities and 1/3 by equity. So what are these assets? Given that Amazon is the largest online retailer in the world, you might expect that inventory would make up a very large percentage of Amazon's assets. However, inventory was just 7% of Amazon's total assets at the end of 2021. The majority of Amazon's assets were actually fixed assets, property, equipment, and operating leases. This makes sense because Amazon not only has lots of fulfillment centers for its retail operations, it also has property and equipment for its Amazon Web Services division. But there's even more you can do with common-sized balance sheets. If we look at a series of them over time, we can identify trends and spot unusual fluctuations. Turning to Netflix, we see that current content assets accounted for nearly 20% of Netflix's total assets at the end of 2018. Yet, current content assets accounted for 0% of Netflix's total assets from 2019 to 2021. This caught my attention. I wondered why such a large asset account would suddenly disappear. After reading Netflix's annual report, I found the answer. Netflix made an accounting change. When Netflix licenses or produces content, it records the cost as a content asset and amortizes that cost over time. When Netflix licensed content prior to 2019, it would record the amount that was available for streaming within the next year as current content assets. But starting in 2019, Netflix began categorizing all licensed content as non-current assets. Now, I probably wouldn't have spotted this change without a common-sized balance sheet. But you need to be careful when performing common-sized analysis. That's because the various line items on a common-sized balance sheet aren't independent from one another. To see what I mean, let's take a look at Amazon's accounts payable as a percentage of assets. This percentage has been decreasing over time, but Amazon's accounts payable has actually been increasing. So why the discrepancy? Amazon's total assets have been increasing a lot faster than its accounts payable. Thus, accounts payable has been decreasing on a relative basis, but increasing on an absolute basis. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to access the spreadsheets that I used to make this video, you'll find a link in the description section below.